Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Let me introduce myself. My name is Brida Novarita Trisanti. I'm from Chemical Engineering Department, Institut Teknologi 10 November, Surabaya. Today, I would like to share about my research. The title is Bionullification Process of Salmon Wood Using Transistors Specifically. And you know, Indonesia has a large area of forest. There is 128 million hectares in the forest in Indonesia. And the large area make Indonesia as the third large area of forest in the world. From forest, Indonesia can produce wood. There is 29% of wood. And the one of the kind wood that can be produced from Indonesia forest is Sengon wood. From this data, we can see from 2014 until 2018, the productivity of Sengon wood is increased by the increases of years. This is can also be seen from the Sengon wood has a high value from economical and very fast growing, only need a 5 until 7 years, and this wood is very easy to cultivate because of the fast growing and easy to cultivation, so the productivity can high too. Usually, Sengon wood can be used as a material to produce particle board and plywood, and because of the production of this kind product, can make or produce the wood. For example, is sawdust wood and pieces of wood from the Sengon. In this wood, has also three component of lignocellulose. There is cellulose, hemicellulose, and lignin. In the Sengon wood, has a very high of cellulose. There is 45% of cellulose. If you want to make high velocity product, for example, micro and nanocrystalline cellulose, so we must remove the lignin and hemicellular content from the sawdust of Sengon wood. So we can use denification process to isolate the cellulose from Sengon wood. This is the three method that can be used to denification. There is physical, chemical, and biological. Physical method, for example, is chipping, grinding, and milling. In this process, will produce very minimal wood, but the energy consumption is very high. And then for chemical method, for example, is alkaline, acid, and organosulfur. Because of the using of chemical, in this method, can produce a chemical wash, so it make this method is non-environmentally friendly. And then biological method, for example, and we can use enzymatic fungi, for example, is white rot fungi. In this process, the wash production is very low, so it make this product as a environmentally friendly method. And from this table, we can see that the denification biomass of biological method is very high and the loss of sugar is very low. The process is very long, it need 2 until 40 days, but if we evaluate the cost, is moderate cost because the waste is very minimal and environmentally friendly. Because of the environmentally impact is positive. So in this process, we choose to use biological process using white rot fungi transmission specifically. This is a problem statement. If we want to isolate the Sengon wood, because of we try to get environmentally friendly, so we choose bionification process using transmission specifically. In this fungi, will be produced enzyme to degrade the lignin and hemicellulose using manganese peroxide, lignin peroxide, and lactase to produce or isolate the cellulose from Sengon wood. This is Sengon wood. The cellulose is very high, is 49%, hemicellulose is 24%, and lignin is 26%. The application is like construction, plywood, mesh, and particle board. In this process, by identification, we choose to use Trametus basic color. The characteristic is irregular semicircular shape, and the growing habitats colonized in a deadwood usually. And this fungi is the one of the effective fungi from Basidiomycota groups to degrade lignin from the wood. This is a methodology. The material we use is wood, Sengon wood sawdust. The size is 40 mesh. And the fungi is Trametus versicolor. Media we use potato dextrose broth and aquatase to washing and process. And this is a variable to the identification process. The first is ratio of sawdust fungi media, 3/2 gram per milliliters, and temperature is 30 degrees Celsius. The identification time is 10, 30, and 5 days. After magnification process, the cellulose will be characterized using JSON analysis and scanning electron microscopy. This is the procedure. First, the dry Sengon wood with the size is 40 mesh will be macerated using aquatase for 24 hours, and then filter to separate the water and the sawdust. After maceration process, the wet sawdust will be sterilization using pressure cooker. After sterilization, we add the Trametus basic color that inoculate in potato dextrose broth, and the process will be use time is 10 until 50 days. After process technification, the fiber will be washing to separate between the sawdust and the fungi, and then drying by using freeze dry, and the dry solid product will be characterized JSON and GN. This is the solid product of sawdust of Sengon wood. Unprocessed have a brown, light brown color, and after magnification process the color is dark until 50 days has a very dark color of sawdust. The dark color because of the work of this enzyme that produce from Trametus basic color to degrade the lignin and hemicellulose. And from the JSON analysis, you can see the component of cellulose, hemicellulose, and lignin. Before process, the JSON has a 45% of cellulose, 60% of hemicellulose, and 21% of cellulose. After gelification process, the content of cellulose was increased by increasing of time gelification, and the lignin content decreased by the increasing of time gelification. You can see from the table, the cellulose has a high content in 50 days. There is 58%. And also the lignin have a lowest content in 50 days of vinification process. There is 3.18%. From this table, we can see that productivity of enzyme increase after 30 days and the high ligning removal achieved on the lowest days, 15 days. And from SEM analysis, we can see the surface morphology of the fiber. Before process, the segment sawdust had the surface is very tight and stacked, and the fiber covered by other component. After maceration with water, the component in the surface of fiber is disappeared partly. And after purification process, there is tears in the outer layer of the fiber, and the fiber look more clearly. This is the conclusion. The purification process can be carried out using drum surface color, and the lignin content of segment dust was decreased by increasing the content of cellulose with the increasing of purification time. The lowest level of lignin was achieved at the longest time of the purification process, that is 15 days. And from the SEM result, the effect of purification process was the tears of the outer layer of segment wood fiber. Thank you very much for your attention.